Listening Library presents The Little Miss Collection, Volume 4, by Roger Hargreaves. Read for you by Jim Dale.
Little Miss Princess, originated by Roger Hargreaves, written and illustrated by Adam Hargreaves. Little Miss Princess's father was a king, and her mother was a queen. Which, as I'm sure you know, meant that Little Miss Princess was a princess. And because she was a princess, she lived in a castle with turrets and a moat, a very big castle. And because she was a princess, she had lots of people to do everything for her. People to mow the lawns, people to cook her breakfast. She even had people to make her bed. And you would imagine that this would have made her rude and spoiled. But she was a kind and generous and good-hearted princess. "I'm so lucky to be a princess. I must spread my luck around," she would say to herself every morning. And she did this by trying to help people. She sent a chef to cook meals for Little Miss Sunshine when she heard that Little Miss Sunshine had the flu. When she overheard Mr. Busy complaining how busy he was, she sent a gardener to mow his lawn. And she sent a maid to Little Miss Neat's house when she heard that Little Miss Neat had worn out her mop. All of this was very useful, and everyone was very grateful, but Little Miss Princess did not feel that she was really doing anything to help. So, when she heard that Mr. Bump had broken his leg, she rushed over to his house to see what she could do. "I haven't got any groceries," said Mr. Bump. "You could go shopping for me." So Little Miss Princess went shopping. But because she was a princess, she had never been shopping. She went into the bakery. "Six sausages, please," she said to the baker. "We don't have any sausages," said the baker. She went into the butcher's shop and asked for peas. "We don't have any peas," said the butcher. And she went into the greengrocery and asked for a loaf of bread. "We don't have any bread," said the greengrocer. So she went back to Mr. Bump's house with an empty shopping basket. "The shops have sold out of everything," she explained to Mr. Bump.
"Everything?" said a puzzled Mr. Bump.
"Yes. The butcher had no peas, the baker had no sausages, and the greengrocer said he didn't have any bread."
"Ah," said Mr. Bump, realizing what had happened. "Why don't you try the supermarket?"
Sometime later, Little Miss Princess returned with the groceries. She offered to help put everything away, but because she was a princess, she had never unpacked the groceries. She put the sausages in the cupboard, the frozen peas in the bread bin, the bread in the drawer, and the milk in the oven. Whoops! After she had put the groceries away, Little Miss Princess offered to clean Mr. Bump's house, but because she was a princess, she had never cleaned anything before. She dusted the dishes, she polished the sofa, and she mopped the carpet. Oh no! Little Miss Princess then went upstairs to make Mr. Bump's bed, but because she was a princess, she had never made a bed. Oh dear! Little Miss Princess then offered to cook supper for Mr. Bump, but because she was a princess, she had never cooked a meal before. For supper, they had burnt sausages with burnt potatoes. She even burned the peas. Oh dear! Said Little Miss Princess, throwing the burnt meal away. "I'm just no good at anything."
"Oh, I wouldn't say that," said Mr. Bump. "I'm sure you are good at all sorts of things."
"Like what?" sniffed Little Miss Princess.
"I know," said Mr. Bump. "Why don't you call for a pizza?"
"What will that prove?" asked Little Miss Princess.
"Well," said Mr. Bump, "you are very good at giving orders."
Little Miss Sunshine and the Wicked Witch.
originated by Roger Hargreaves, written and illustrated by Adam Hargreaves. Little Miss Sunshine was going for a walk. The weather was not very nice, but it takes a lot more than a bit of rain to dampen Little Miss Sunshine's spirits. In the distance, she saw Little Miss Bossy approaching. I will be nice to Little Miss Bossy, thought Little Miss Sunshine, so she won't boss me around. However, as she got closer, the most incredible thing happened. There was a bright flash, and Little Miss Bossy turned into a bat. A blue, very squeaky, bossy sort of a bat. How extraordinary! Exclaimed Little Miss Sunshine as she watched Little Miss Bossy flap her wings and fly away. But almost as extraordinary was the cackling laugh Little Miss Sunshine thought she heard coming from the clouds above. The next day was much nicer. The sun was out, and there was not a cloud in sight. Little Miss Sunshine was happily walking along, wondering what happened to Little Miss Bossy, when she saw Mr. Rood walking toward her. I will be nice to Mr. Rood, thought Little Miss Sunshine, or he will be rude to me. But at that moment there was a bright flash. And when Little Miss Sunshine reached where Mr. Rood had been standing, she discovered that he had turned into a toad, a red, very rude, angry-looking toad. And just like the day before, Little Miss Sunshine heard a cackling laugh, but this time it seemed to be coming from a nearby tree. On her walk the following day, Little Miss Sunshine had nearly caught up with Little Miss Ditzy when there was another blinding flash. Little Miss Ditzy had turned into a mouse, a very confused, ditzy, blonde-haired mouse. When Little Miss Sunshine heard the same laugh she had heard the 2 days before, she ducked behind a bush and waited to see if she could find out who it came from. Suddenly, with a rustle of leaves, a witch flew out from behind a tree, a wicked witch on a broomstick.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.